December 24, 1942, Christmas Eve. What we began at Stalingrad.
Your orders are to take control of the enemy airfield near Tatsinskaya to prevent them from resupplying the 6th Army at Stalingrad. This is a critical mission, comrades. Best of luck.
Raven, this is platoon leader. What is your status, over?
Platoon leader, Raven here. Our trucks are in position. We need 10 minutes to set up the rockets. Over.
Hold positions until... Suka! Stuka! Incoming! We have been spotted! Raven, we cannot wait! Get your rockets in position now! We will take care of those bombers!
crew. We can't get through to the airfield until somebody takes them out.
From the vehicle, dismount.
This building is crawling with Germans. We need to clear it out.
Attention, all remaining units regroup at the train depot. We need more tanks to breach the airfield.
Thank you. Sir, the fascists have barricaded themselves inside the control tower.
Let's gather some intelligence for headquarters.
Certainly make some heads turn. Let's get back to headquarters.
Nice bonfire you lit up today, comrades. That should keep us warm most of the winter.
By controlling North Africa, the Axis powers would have a better chance of holding the Mediterranean, now the epicenter of the war. Unfortunately for Italian dictator Benito Mussolini, his army is ill-prepared to withstand the British forces in the region. Hitler, fearful that more losses in Africa would jeopardize his efforts on the Russian front, sends General Rommel and his Africa Corps to clean up the mess. By 1942, the Allies decide that the best way to break the Axis powers back is to create another front. An Operation Torch is born of British and American troops. A well-supported, coordinated push through enemy lines, depleting and destroying fuel, food, and equipment, would mean the eventual fall of the Third Reich in Africa, weakening Axis aggression throughout the world. All goes as planned, and by January 1943,
my wife finally wrote saying, Edward Carlyle, just asked to do something else. So I did. It turns out having a background in teaching chemistry can get you out of a desk job pretty quick if you have a mind to it. I knew nothing of Popsky's private army or its ties to the Desert Rats until I was in training. This sabotage platoon's philosophy is lightning-fast strikes and massive explosions deep behind enemy lines. It's gratifying to know that every time we light up a fuel depot or munitions dump, we're stalling Rommel's tanks and helping those poor blighters on the front lines. It may not be fighting fair, but the Germans have hardly fought fair in Europe, so to hell with them. My assignments are highly confidential, so as far as the wife knows, I'm still sitting at a desk. But for some strange reason, I've stopped complaining.
Listen up, chaps. The Jerrys have a cozy little setup in this village here. Our job is to break as much equipment as possible and then dash out before they even know what hit them. Troop B will drive the jeeps behind the Germans and pepper them with machine gun fire. I lead Troop A through town to knock out their communications and burn up their petrol reserves. Carlyle, you're the man with the demolitions. We'll cover you while you set the time to save four charges. We'll have to get in and out before everything becomes all spotlights, sirens, and rifles firing. Cock your guns, wet your sights, and ride on. Let's go!
Thank you.
bombs on that panzer. Genischen geschossen. Verschnockt mal.
Oh, get ready, Carlisle.
These wires must lead to their communication points.
Charge on that antenna. Ding dong.
So they can move forward.
Take that machine gun and throw some lead back at those cherries!
Yeah.
set a charge on that generator. Once this last charge goes off, Fritz will be completely out of power. All right, get ready to brake and ready to dash. Let's go! Everybody to bed by now. Let's move out. Somebody's left some perfectly good landmines lying around. We'll have to fight our way to the petrol depot. Follow me and watch out for more Panzers. We'll have to fight our way to the petrol depot. Follow me and watch out for more Panzers.
short on tank. We'll have to get to that depot. Time. Get in!
Looks like we're in the clear.
Hang on, Connor.
Navigating the desert like an ocean of sand, you have to know where you're going and have a plan to get in and out as quickly and quietly as possible. We do prefer it when quietly is not required. The one thing that allows us to hit the enemy where it hurts most is our jeeps. They're always loaded with enough fuel, supplies, and water to travel 600 miles at a stretch. Although unarmored, they can be heavily armed with two 50 cal MGs firing armor-piercing and incendiary rounds. These make us quick and deadly when we need to be, able to take on German half-tracks and armored cars that outclass us in every other way. Still, this doesn't make up for the fact that you're completely exposed to fire sitting in an open jeep. And you'd better have a damn good driver at the wheel should trouble arise. And it always does, mate.
Look alive, Carlisle! I got word on the wireless that some of our old mates from the Long Range Desert Group are lying doggo in an old fortress surrounded by Jerry's. We've got to save them. Those chaps found a shortcut through the desert that leads straight to Rommel's back door. You and I are leading the charge. The rest of the men will catch up with us at the fort. Protect my hide while I refuel the jeep. Keep your eyes peeled. We won't be alone for long.
Sniper!
Watch out!
Starkey, we've spotted Fritz bearing down on your position. Avoid contact and proceed to rendezvous point.
Oh dear.
Incoming!
They must be stuck in that far tower. The hack is still up. I'll go ahead. Reach the field.
He was captured and taken underground. We need to save him.
Fire!
the cartographer. He was captured and taken underground. We need to save him. underground, now!
Ace, Acey!
Up in the air!
It's about time you chaps showed up.
Well, we had a few errands to run.
Hey, Carlisle, were you just gonna leave me out there?
By 1944, in the battle to regain their Russian homeland, the Red Army crushes the German pocket at Stalingrad, marking the first major defeat of Hitler's armies. On June 6th, D-Day, the Allies stage a massive sea and air invasion on the Normandy coast that will soon lead across France and Belgium. Inspired by this success, British Field Marshal Montgomery devises a plan he insists will end the war by Christmas, codenamed Market Garden. With momentum on their side, the Allies attack Germany's industrial heartland from the north, attempting to outflank the powerful Siegfried Line, intending to drive on to Berlin. But Montgomery's plan fails miserably when the final bridge across the Rhine cannot be secured. Painful defeat and staggering losses destroy all hope for an early end to the war, and surviving Allies are ordered back to France. Fortunately, by October, with the Siegfried Line finally breached from the west, the Americans prepare for the capture of Aachen, a city destined for the dubious distinction of being the first major German city to fall to Allied forces.
My name is Chuck Walker. I've been attached to the First Army, the Big Red One, for a long time now. I fought in North Africa and Sicily. I landed in Normandy on D-Day. Every day I fight to save my life and the lives of my men. I'm proud we're on the front lines. I know none of us are going home until the Germans surrender completely, and we want to be right there when it happens. And that's why Aachen is so important. It's time to take this fight right to Germany, where it began. This isn't about medals or honor. Those things don't matter when you're fighting for your life. This is about winning the war. And fighting with the Big Red One has taught me you win a war by surviving it. And that means killing the Germans before they kill me. This is it. We're taking Aachen today. The Germans in the town square are cut off from their command and control. But those old buildings are solid enough to resist shelling. Orders are to escort the M12 to the town square, clearing buildings of German resistance on the way. Once we're inside the city hall, the M12 will blow the sumbitch to pieces. Stay close behind the tanks for cover and protect them from German anti-armor. We lose the Shermans and we're all dead. Let's saddle up and get it done.
Sarge, some of those old buildings are too fortified for the tanks to take out. What are we gonna do about them?
Relax, Benny. We're gonna knock them all down.